Dealing with bent or uneven rectangular section wire can be a real challenge. So today I'm introducing the Tandem Wire Straightener, a new benchtop tool designed to straighten and smooth out rectangular wire perfectly. For those of you eager to see it in action, feel free to skip ahead to the live wire processing demonstration in the second part of the video. Hello everybody, I'm Eros and welcome back to my workshop. Let's get started. I'll begin with the latch design. My initial idea was for lateral latches, but they were not so great to use and kinda in the way. For the second design, I came up with this articulated arm, but wasn't a big fan of the first version. It needed both a custom pin and printing supports, not ideal. So I replaced the axle articulation with a captive one. This eliminated both the custom pin and the need for printing supports. Now onto the treadle knobs. Initially, I was holding them whatever way I could, and this often led to the knobs being threaded crooked. To spare myself this misery, I came up with this very simple bearing jig with replaceable adapters for various knobs. This way I can thread the knobs with my eyes closed and still get them threaded dead straight. This is the quick release header. It uses these bolts' heads as alignment guides that will match with their corresponding holes in the tool body. Next, I'm installing the tensioning knobs into the quick release header. To somehow guide the wire in the perpendicular axis, I came up with these floating steel rollers, for which I printed several iterations until I got a good snap fit. Once satisfied with the fit, I'm proceeding with installing all four rollers into the body and the dedicated brackets. Next, the four fixed rollers get installed. Then I'm installing the bearings in the adjustable blocks. Then the painful to install lock nuts. There are four of them, two for each possible mounting position. Here I'm installing the blocks holding the matching guiding rollers. These pairs of rollers will act as constraining points for the wire to keep it roughly in the action area of the actual bearings. And now I'm installing the adjustable bearing blocks. With all these in place, it's time for the final step: installing the top with the quick release latches. There, the first unit is done and looking like candy. And by the power of good organizing skills, the second unit is done too. Since this is a tandem, it's time to finally mount the two units at a 90 degrees angle to each other. The two units are aligned by design so that the fixed rollers form the fixed corner of a cross-section tunnel, while the adjustable ones form the opposing adjustable corner, allowing the formation of a rectangular maximum 6 mm or roughly a quarter inch section adjustable tunnel. Now let's see this baby in action. I'm using some pretty crooked 2x2 mm or 3/32 of an inch copper wire here for demo purposes. And fitting it for the first time is a bit rougher, but to be expected, so I prepared in advance by setting the adjustable rollers to be a bit loose. But after just one pass, the big kinks are already taken out. And increasing a bit the pressure on the adjustable rollers helps take out the rest of the kinks. A bit more pressure for good measure. And it's smooth. but not very straight. So now I'm doing the final step, which is taking all the pressure off, then reapplying pressure carefully just until the adjustable rollers start engaging. Doing just a couple more passes under this almost zero pressure straightens out the wire. Taking out the large radius curve resulted in the kinks removal step. And we're done. The wire is now so smooth and straight you can barely notice me advancing it along my palm. Well, that's it for now. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.